About a year ago, I was given an opportunity, and my daughter and my family, to be a part of this. You know, I came home as a parent, you know, just sitting outside the fence, and one day I just said, hey, I can help out, you know. And I helped out, it's gone a long way. I had a lot of opportunities, as well as my daughter. And, you know, Philip Love, which, you know, Georgia Shockers gave me that opportunity.
Yeah.
And I'm very appreciative of that. You know, it opened up a lot of doors for me to help others. And others will help me. I'd like to thank all the parents, you know, for allowing their children this opportunity to come out here and play ball. And that's why we're all here. It's about the kids and opportunity and us teaching them not just playing ball. There's a lot of life lessons involved with this also. Okay? You know, you feel like you fail, you pick yourself up and you teach them how to do that. And you work together. We've all learned a lot together. You know, I don't know all the right answers all the time. But I have a supporting cast of, you know, the coaches. I got, you know, Ben and Ferris, and they're always there for me. You know, if I don't know something, it's okay. And they make it seem like it's okay. During the tournaments, you know, families, we brave the heat, the cold, lack of sleep, all the ups and downs. But at the end of the day, that's what softball families do. You know, we stick together and we fight through it. And that's going to help these young ladies at the end of the day. Like I said, the coaching staff I had was awesome. And I've watched the tournaments, you know, 14U and seen Gina and Vince. I've seen you guys and I learned from you also. And I'm thankful for that. And to the girls, I hope y'all take this experience of playing ball and from this season and apply it to life. Learn to take the good with the bad and how to work hard and improve. If you fail, pick yourself up. Never fear hard work, because that's what life's about, is hard work. Okay? Just keep working. Take every memory you have, not just from this season, but, you know, and cherish them. Look forward to making more. Hey, you girls are going to see a lot of each other, other teams, middle school, high school teams, but love each other, okay? Because y'all work hard every week, and I couldn't be more proud of a group of girls than the 10U Shockers. I think we ought to give them a hand right now. First up is the Who's Who Award. Emily Pressman. Come see me. As well as that award, she gets a participation award also for taking part. And this is something else. We got a Who's Who 2 award. Sydney Pressman. We have one that for a little while wasn't with us and came back to practice thinking, you know, hey, this is going to be a little rushing. She come back to practice on fire. Our Missing in Action Award goes to Taylor Digna.
Taylor.
This award, I'm not going to say a name, and let's see if we can figure out. And you know, the Rump Shaker Award.
Presley. Rump Shaker. Gotta show it.
That's Mr. This next award is not going to surprise anybody at all, because she's like, we got our own little superhero on the team, and we're going to call her the Encourager, and we've already seen why. Okay, and
Yo, Joe!
You have to get it.
Yeah, he's like, let me do it.
Next award. This little one came up to me at a practice, after a practice, and says, Coach Dave, what time did it be a shot? And, you know, for somebody to do that, pretty awesome, but this is my half-pint shocker, Taylor Snyder.
Tay-Tay!
Man, he's getting pretty rough. I apologize. You know, spending all this time with these girls, you gotta love them. I mean, it's what it's all about. This one, in a game practice, and this is what you kind of want, but this is I Got It Every Time Award. It don't matter how close or how far she's away, she's going to call it. We call her Smunky.
Smunky!
During the game, she'll walk up and say, Coach, am I left or right? Where do I bat at today? And it's fun, but you always get that look. It's like, which one is it? Reese facing.
Yay!
She's just wide open all the time. Every time she's running, whatever. This is our Go Speed Racer Award, Reagan Carbomb.
She's so tiny.
This little, every time you see her in the dugout, she's gonna come out like this. Cheek full of sunflowers. So we're gonna call this one the Sunflower Power Award.
Olivia! Got a whole pack in her mouth.
Smiley Award, Megan Jenkins. The next award, and you know, you think about line leaders and you wonder if your line's always good or bad, but I promise you, you're going to be the third line leading something. Alyssa Beatenboat.
Boosie.
Call this Ice Ice Baby, Madison Sue. Who do we have left?
The Beast.
The Beast.
The Beast.
AJ Jackson. First of all, the most improved, we had three different girls up for this, three different coaches, three different choices. We sent out a vote, there was 14 people voted, come back 6-4-4, just to show you how much where our team has come from. But in the end, Olivia Chin.
Woo, Olivia!
Next award is going to be best offense. This one got on base, but she did a lot. And when she got on base, she was still on base. Second, third, it didn't matter. AJ Jackson.
Go AJ!
The next award is going to be best defense, and this award came with a lot of hard work. You don't always start that way, but as the season progressed, you just seen a big change, and always going forward, the best defense goes to Presley Snyder.
Yay, Presley!
Leave it to Presley. Okay. Next award is the Super Shocker Award. And this is that child 150% all the time. If she's late to practice, you can look up and she's running to get there. And you appreciate that. I mean, because guess what? The kids can't drive. But when they get there, they want to get to the field, and it's always this, yes sir, no sir, never anything other than that, and always want to get better. Reagan Quattlebaum. This one, it don't matter if she's pitching, playing first base, sitting in the dugout, she's going to be cheering her teammates on, and she's going to have her coaches back all the time. Shock of spirit, Joey Burdette.
Yeah, JoJo!
The next award is going to be MVP. This kid came a long way. I went back and looked at quotes, and I seen one game in the tournament where this child was pitching and she threw three balls the whole game. I couldn't be more proud. Lisa Lisa.